Barring a last-minute stay of execution, Georgia tonight will put to death the first woman since 1945 in that state. This morning, her attorneys filed an emergency request for a 90-day stay with the Board of Pardons and Paroles, not to execute Kelly Gissendaner. They've already declined her denied her clemency, though. Gissendaner is the only woman on Georgia's death row, the only one. She's convicted of conspiring with a boyfriend to kill her husband in 1997. At the time, Gissendaner tried to appear as the concerned and worried wife.
If he's somewhere that he can get to a phone, just for him to please call home and let somebody know he's all right. If it's not calling me, to call his parents or something. That's all I want him home.
That was 1997, and now we're almost two decades later. And we're also joined by the Episcopal priest and Reverend Cathy Zappa, who's the director of the prison theology program that Kelly Gissendaner participated in. Reverend, thank you so much for taking the time to be with us today. I just want to ask you, what are your efforts right now to stop this scheduled execution just now, 6 hours and 10 minutes from now?
Well, there are a lot of things going on right now and a lot of people involved. As you know, the attorneys have filed a plea for a stay of execution in the hopes that the board will hear some new evidence and reconsider some of what they've heard. There are petitions going around. I think there are over 100,000 signatures on one petition asking for clemency. And there's another letter going around that's been signed by faith leaders all over the country from many different faiths. My efforts are in just trying to let people know that there is another side of Kelly Gissendaner, a side that has emerged over the last 18 years of her incarceration.
And I know that is critical to a lot of people. And then there is this other side where it doesn't matter one iota that Ms. Gissendaner has changed. Right. They only look at the crime and that the legal system played out, and that no matter what might have arisen since then, nothing went wrong legally. Do you respect that?
I do not respect that, because what's been so troublesome about this particular case is, why have clemency if the 18 years of incarceration don't matter? Why have a clemency hearing if what she does in that meantime doesn't matter? The board has the power to weigh these situations and see. And what I'm hoping they see is that there's a life that is of value in the prison and in our world right now. The whole prison system is built around the idea of rehabilitation. This is a woman who has been rehabilitated. To deny that is to not deny a lot of what the Department of Corrections is about. She also has been denied in this process. This process has been a very torturous process. She's been denied a lot of things that I think any human being should have in this process. For example, she wanted her chaplain of 16 years to be with her today, and she was denied that request. She wanted to receive last rites from her chaplain of 16 years and was denied that request. So part of it too is how this is playing out. There's a side of it that a lot of us don't see until you're up close to it.
So I suppose the question I have for you is this, and it's so hard to speak in these terms when you're really facing an actual scheduled death at the hands of the government. Do you think that your actions with respect to Kelly Gissendaner are going to have an effect on her execution? Or do you think perhaps your work might change things down the line for others?
I hope it's both. I hope it has an impact. I hope people hear. I hope there's pressure on the board and the governor and just this whole state to see what we're doing. This is unconscionable. And seeing it up close, it's not just an execution. It has been 18 years of spiritual, emotional, psychological torture that is continuing in this time.
What about the family who was so terribly affected by the murder of her then husband?
Right.
How are they weighing in on this, and her own children?
Right. The family has been split by this. It's a horrible tragedy. It's a crime, and it has had devastating effects on the entire family. Doug Gissendaner's parents obviously are devastated. I haven't talked to them, but it's very clear that they're weighing on in favor of the execution. I can't say I understand their anger and their hurt, but I respect it, and I imagine it's very hard for them to see people like me coming out in defense of Kelly. Her children are also victims of this crime, and they have been in the process of rebuilding a relationship with her, and they do not want her executed. So I think that to execute her would be to re-victimize them, would be to make them victims all over again.
Well, we, without question, really appreciate you taking the time to speak with us about this, and it is, it's something we will be watching today. We watched this last week, and then weather, of all things, weather changed the scheduled execution, but we'll see if there's anything else that changes scheduled execution.
Yeah, and I hope we all keep her in our prayers.
Cathy Zappa, thank you so much for being with us. I appreciate
thank
it.
You.